Our next speaker did not own a franchise, but he did own a very successful independent company in San Diego, California, just such a beautiful place, my birth town where I was born. And he built a huge business doing hundreds of millions of dollars a year. I think he came to us, I'm guessing 150, 180, 200 million. I don't know, today he's doing a lot more. But I'll let him tell the story. But he brought his successful independent company to eXp, and the results have been magical. Help me welcome to the stage, Mr. Kyle Whistle, everybody. Woo!
It feels so freaking good to be on a stage again. Feels so good to be around my friends, around my family. Feels good to be hungover in the morning, sweating it out on a treadmill. Conferences are back, baby. Shit is fun, right? So, check it out. You guys have heard a ton of amazing stories. I've been super inspired by everybody who's been up here. And honestly, if you're not inspired by now, just go home. Honestly, if all these big-ass stories haven't got you pumped up, if you're not motivated by now, I'm sorry, there's no hope for you. Just go home. Seriously. Or just go to the pool and get drunk, and I'll see you there soon. All right. So what I want to do today, I'm actually not going to tell any stories. I'm going to go super, super, super tactical. I'm going to give you guys 13 things. So get your pen, get your paper. You're about to write a lot of shit down. So number one, these are the 13 most important things if you guys want to grow. Number one is reputation management. I see so many people screw this up all the time. I see people constantly talking shit about everybody. You've got to know anything that you say about somebody is gonna get around to that person. I don't care who you are telling it to. I don't care how much you trust them. I don't care how good of a friend you are with that person. The things that you say about people will get around to that person. The things you say about other brokerages will get around to that brokerage. Take the high road all the time, because that negativity, all that's gonna do is surround you with negativity. Don't win that way. That's not the way you win this game. Don't try to push other people down. Pull people up. That's how you win in this. So be very, very careful about what you say, guys. Number two, sell a shit ton of houses. You want to attract people? Attract them by selling a ton of houses. Right? Because here's the thing. How many of you guys got your real estate license to be a stockbroker? Anybody? None, right? I can't see a damn person. Any of you guys get your license to be a stockbroker? Nope. Any of you guys get your real estate license to be a recruiter? Anybody? Nope. You guys got your license to sell homes. People are attracted to people who sell homes because that's why they got their license. We all got our license because we want to sell a shit ton of homes. So go sell a shit ton of homes and watch what happens. Now people start calling you, right? We use the term attraction. You want to attract people, sell a shit ton of homes. That's how you attract. So get out there, sell a ton of homes. I want to give you a little bit of verbiage tweak that I see people screw up all the time. Don't post, oh, we have 62 closed and pending this month. What the hell does that mean? Do you think anybody knows what closed and pending means outside of realtors? Talk about how many families you've helped. Because that's why we do this, right? We talk about home ownership. It's the American dream. Talk about how you're helping people live their dream. Talk about how you're helping families. Quit posting, 62 closed and pending this quarter. Shut up, that's stupid. Sorry, I'm very honest. You guys never seen me speak, I'm brutally honest. So talk about how many families you've helped, because that makes it very attractive. Do you think any of your clients want to be considered a closed and pending? Your clients are following you. Quit posting about how many closed and pending. That's families helped, families served. Dreams realized. Use terms like that. That's going to make it a lot more sticky for you. Next up, I want you guys to start volunteering to speak. You realize, this is the first event. How freaking good does it feel to be here, right? How good does it feel to grab a drink at the bar? How good does it feel to give somebody a hug, a high five, or that awkward, are we playing rock, paper, scissors? I don't know, right? It's cool, but it feels good. It feels good. It's awkward, but we're getting there. It feels good. The demand, the craving for community on the back end of COVID is going to be higher than ever. You know how many people wanted to be in this room today that couldn't? There's tons of people, hundreds if not thousands of people that want to be in this room. You're here. So take advantage of it. You guys have a huge opportunity. But understand that there's going to be a lot of events, and there's going to be a lot of opportunity for you to get up and share and to speak. So I want you to volunteer everywhere. Volunteer at the local board of realtors. Volunteer at the Young Professional Network. Volunteer with the Chamber of Commerce. Volunteer with NAREB, ARIA, NAREB. Like, volunteer with all of these groups. Like, get involved. They need speakers. They want speakers. I used to piss my freaking pants when I thought about speaking. I would sit up here, like, if they gave me a microphone, it would be fucking shaking. It was terrible. Do it. The best way to get over your fear of speaking is to get on a big-ass stage. Just do it. The best way to get over your fear of heights is to skydive. The best way to get over your fear of the ocean is to shark dive. Just do it. Just dive in. Start speaking. Just go for it. You got to get out there. You got to speak. And you might say, well, I don't sell enough homes. Nobody wants me to speak. Okay, still volunteer yourself, but guess what? Guess who you can ask to speak? You can ask Facebook to speak. You could ask Instagram to speak. You could ask LinkedIn to speak. You could ask TikTok to speak. You think they're going to say no? Grab your damn phone, hit the live button, and just speak. If you can't get on a stage, you can't get on a Zoom, you can't get on a panel, that's fine. Speak to Facebook Live. Oh, only 5 people watch. How many watched the video you didn't shoot yesterday? Because that's 5 more than the people who watched the video you didn't shoot. I'll take 5 over 0. So get out there, volunteer to speak, share. Don't be afraid. Oh, they're going to copy what I do. You know what? We had 3 of the top 5 teams in San Diego County, all with EXP. Why? Because we share. Come from an abundance mindset. Don't have that scarcity mindset. Plus, 99% of the people aren't going to do shit with what you teach them anyway. It's fine. So get over it. They're not going to steal everything that you do. It's okay. But speak. Get yourself out there. Put yourself out there. Add value. People will appreciate that. All right, this one. Grab your phones. Some of you guys have reception. Some of you guys don't. I think I got it now that I'm up here. So I want you to go to Facebook and just open up the first random friend that pulls up at the top of your list. Doesn't matter who it is. Just grab that first friend, load their profile, and you're going to see their picture, their name. There's going to be a message button, a phone button, and 3 little dots. Tap on those 3 dots. There's 2 things that are really important in here. One is this friends button. When you have this friends button, there's something called lists. You should have a list for all the people that you're in conversations with about attracting to this company. You should have all of those people in a list. I have my farm in my list. I have targets in my list. Make lists of all these people. Because what does it allow you to do? You can now actually go in on Facebook, and instead of seeing all the noise, all the bullshit on there, you can just load that one specific list, and you can now see all of those people so that your time can be a lot more efficient on Facebook, where you could just go in there and say, hey, load up my farm list, and I could go comment on all the people in my farm's post. I could load up my attraction list, and I could comment on all the people who I'm trying to attract. I need to engage with those people. The better job I do of engaging with those people, I need to stay on their radar. I gotta stay on those people's radar. So that's one way to do it. The other way to do it is I want you to tap the following button. And you're gonna see 3 things. One says unfollow. One says default. Some of you guys might unfollow me because I cuss. That's okay. Unfollow, default, and favorites. That favorites button is magic. Because if you tap that favorites button, now every time you load up Facebook, if somebody is marked as a favorite and they've posted, guess who's at the top of your feed? It's that person. So if you've got somebody you're engaged with, somebody that you want to build a relationship, somebody that you're working on, you put them on that list for attraction and you save them as a favorite because now you're going to see their post every time they post. Now you can engage with them because you've got to stay on people's radar. You don't want to constantly have to call and text them. Just engage with them on social. It's all about top of mind awareness, so engage with that person. So now go over to your Instagram. Load up somebody. Load up their profile. You're going to see their name across the top, their picture, post, followers, following, and you're going to see this little bell. I want you to tap on that bell. When you do, you're going to see something called notifications that pulls up. Turn that shit on. If you got somebody that you're working, if you're trying to build a relationship with somebody, you're trying to attract somebody, turn that shit on. Now you're going to get notified every time that person posts. That's how you stay engaged with people. People want to know that you care about what they have going on in their lives. And now with the algorithm, you're probably going to miss 90% of their posts. But if you turn this on, now you get notified. Now you can go in there And now you can start engaging with those people. I have certain, there's a lot of these channel partners we refer to them, like Homelight and Zillow and Opcity and all these things. I have all those people that I'm trying to work those relationships with. I've got this turned on Instagram. I've got them saved as a favorite on Facebook. I've got them in my list. Every time they post, I'm engaging, right? Their kid scored a goal at soccer. I'm gonna engage with it. They had some sort of win at work. I'm gonna engage with it. The more you engage with people, the more you're gonna win with them. Everybody wants to know that you're paying attention to what they're doing. It makes them feel good. Next up, one-to-one videos. Video is something that we're known for. We're actually doing far less public video, far less edited professional video, way more one-to-one video. One-to-one video is me sending a video directly to Glenn. That's a one-to-one video. Me sending a video to Michael, me sending a video to Dave. One-to-one videos are the most powerful thing in the world. So what do you send one-to-one videos for? Well, birthdays, wedding anniversaries, or just because. Dan was up here, mentioned Treasure Davis on Thanksgiving this year. Instead of just sending everybody like a lame-ass Happy Thanksgiving text like a bunch of you guys do, I shot everybody that mattered to me just a one-to-one video. Just saying thank you. Thank you for what you do. Thank you for all that you do for this industry, right? Show people that you care. Shooting that one-to-one video is a huge reason why Treasure's here today. It's because I took the time to shoot her a video, a very personal, heartfelt video, on Thanksgiving. Are you doing that ever? Whether they're people that are already in your organization, people that are exploring your organization, people that are on your team. I shot one to one of my admins on Saturday. She's off on Saturday, but she was sending emails. I just shot her a video. Hey Shannon, I just wanted to let you know I appreciate you. I know it's Saturday. I know it's your day off. I see that you're putting in some work, and I just want to let you know I really appreciate that. That made her day. It was a 10-second video. That made her freaking day that I acknowledged her, that I took the time, 10 seconds out of my day, to shoot her that video. So are you doing that? Make a goal. Shoot 5 a day. Shoot 10 a day. If you do them on Facebook Messenger, the maximum length's 30 seconds. So if you make a goal to shoot 10 a day, it can't take any more than 5 minutes to do it. So make that a goal walking out of here. Commit to shooting 10 one-to-one videos every single day. If I was you guys, I'd do it to every single person who was up on this stage. Start building relationships with everybody who was up here. Next up, leverage your toolbox. So you got to look at everybody in this room is part of your toolbox. Understand everybody's strengths and weaknesses. Where are they strong? Where can this person help? Right? Like I've got Dan Beer. Dan is a fantastic business person, one of the best, sharpest business people I know, and does a massive amount of farming. Farms 20, 30,000 doors, and he used to be with KW. So if I'm talking to somebody who's at KW, I'm gonna bring Dan in, because he could speak that language. He's been there. They heard about him when he was there. I've got somebody who runs a big independent brokerage. I'm calling Chuck Fazio. He moved a 900-person independent brokerage over. He's a tool. I'm gonna use him when I need him, right? And he's gonna use me when he needs me. I got Jay Kinder, I got Michael Reese, and those are the people that are in my line. I got Veronica over here. Like, I'll lean on Veronica when I need her, and she'll do the same thing, right? She's a part of my toolbox. I'm gonna use her, she's gonna use me. That's how we do this, that's how we win. I got Pete Middleton. Pete, yeah, I got your shout out, I didn't forget. Pete's in San Diego. He's not in my line, that's fine. But I was talking to somebody who wanted to talk to somebody about luxury. And I was like, hey, Pete, can you help me out? Can you have a conversation with this person? Pete's like, absolutely, buddy. Wicked awesome. I'll do it. Pete hopped on and helped me out with that call. So understand the tools that are in your toolbox and leverage them. We're all here to help. So utilize that. Know who you've got at your disposal. Hopefully you guys are doing events. And if you are, give people a little sneak peek at what you're doing. We do a mastermind every Monday. Well, what does a mastermind mean? We tell people, yeah, every Monday you can hop on, you can pick my brain, Mary Maloney, Dan Beer, like pick our brains, right? We did 15 million in GCI last year. Like, what would it be like to hop on every Monday and pick our brains? Well, it's one thing to talk about it, but it's another to actually invite them to be a part of it, right? Like Cheplak says, be their broker before you become their broker. Show them what it's gonna be like to be there before they're there. So invite them to hop on that mastermind. Don't be like, oh, you can't come on until you join. This is only for people who are in. Shut up, let them in. Open the doors, guys. Like, quit keeping everything closed. Like, open up, open kimono. life will be a lot better. So give people a sneak peek of what it would be like to get in your group, to mastermind with you before they join you. Next up, I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the people that are already in your organization. Big one is get people plugged in when they join. The way this works, it's not like, all right, got them. No, like get them plugged in. Help them understand what to do once they're a part of your organization. Help them understand all the benefits. Like, what does it mean to be a part of whatever you choose to call your group? Like, make it known. Oh, by the way, we do a mastermind every Monday. We do a power hour every Tuesday. We got a training every Wednesday. We got coaching every Thursday. Like, let them know. Hopefully you have a Facebook group. And now you can invite them into that Facebook group where you can tag them in all this stuff. Help them understand what they get by being here. Don't ever assume people know all this stuff. Like, you know it. You might have built it all yourself. So it's second nature to you. But don't assume they know everything. Don't assume that they know they can hop on a leadership meeting every single Friday. Don't assume they know that they can get on with their broker whatever day of the week it is in their state. Don't assume they know that they need to download Workplace, that they need to join certain groups, and that there's a Workplace app and a Workplace chat app, and they're two different things. Don't assume this stuff. Help them understand this. Hold their hand. Walk them through. These guys are doing the best they can, but we're their sponsor. This is part of our job, is to help them get ingrained into this company. So help them understand what's available to them. Help them understand the tools and everything that comes along with it. Like I mentioned, make sure you have a Facebook group. We tried, love you guys, but we tried to have everybody in our organization be in a Workplace group. Couldn't get as much engagement. Came to an event last year, a couple of you guys, Adam Bailey, a couple of other people, were like, dude, get off that, just go on Facebook. Our engagement is through the roof. So get everybody in your organization into a Facebook group. The amount of interaction that's happening, the amount of engagement that's happening within our organization is massive. And now we can put all this content in there. So maybe somebody can't get on that mastermind on Monday, but we could put the recording of it in that group and now they could watch it and get that value. Because the more value you provide, the longer people are gonna stay with you and the more they're gonna tell other people about what it's like to be with you. So build yourself a Facebook group, get in there, get engaged, and connect with people. Public acknowledgement. Veronica posted about this, and her and Gil and Carlos and those guys do an amazing job. Vincent, they're constantly shouting people out publicly. Whenever I've done an exit interview with an agent on my team, and I ask them, like, what's the one thing that we do really well? They always mention the fact that I took time to post on my personal Facebook page a shout out about them. Every single time they mention that. They mention that that is the most valuable thing ever, that I took the time, one, to write a post, and two, to put it on my personal wall, not on the company one. It matters way more that it's coming on my personal page, because now it's coming from me, not from the company. I can't tell you how valuable those are. So whether it's like an agent of the month post, or just the girl who was putting in the work on the Saturday on her day off, like, put that stuff out there. Share it on your personal page. That will be more valuable than anything. You don't have to give people money. You don't have to take them on fancy trips. Just acknowledge them publicly? Holy crap, man, that is so, so valuable. Next up is, I need you guys to breed leaders. You guys are here at this amazing event. I personally want to take time. Brent, love you. But this guy up here, this bald-headed dude, this guy is the one who makes all this shit happen. Like, he is, James is such an unsung hero. Like, this event doesn't happen without James. Like, I love this guy. He works his ass off. And dude, you deserve everything that's coming to you. So appreciate you. So you're here at this event. This is a great event. You're inspired. What are you gonna do when you go home? Are you gonna just wait for Brent to throw his next event, or are you gonna throw one? Why can't you do this? What's stopping you from throwing your own event? You're all capable. Maybe you're like, oh, well, I'm not the best speaker, whatever. That's fine. There's something called Bar Camp. This is a format we use. We do a lot of masterminds. Bar Camp, the way this worked, everybody got together at a bar, and I'm like, I could talk about video. Veronica's like, I could talk about Zillow. Pete's like, I could talk about luxury. Everybody volunteered to speak about something, and then everybody voted like, oh yeah, let's talk about that, that, and that. And then those people spoke about it. The person hosting it, all they had to do was introduce people. They actually didn't even have to speak. They just invited everybody to a place, and then everybody volunteered to speak. And that was the content of the event. So invite all of your people. Everybody shows up. So the way this works is you give everybody a little post-it note. They write their topic, put them up on the wall. Once all the topics are up, everybody gets a pen. Go put check marks. You get 3 check marks. So put check marks on the 3 topics you want to hear about. And whichever ones have the most check marks, that's the content for your event. Super easy. You guys can all go home and do that. There's no reason you can't do that today. So one of the greatest honors for Dan and I is when people in our group start throwing events. Jeremy Larson just threw a really killer event up in Santa Cruz. Treasure Davis just threw a killer event up in Colorado Springs. Like, that's the shit. When your people start being the ones throwing these events. Don't just come here and absorb the content. Go create an event. Learn what you could learn here. See what they do. And now take it out and do that at home. Maybe there's only 20 people that come. That's fine. Guess what? You're going to do a great event. And the next time, 40. Before you know it, you got a freaking whole theater and everybody flying down to Cabo for your event. So start throwing some events, guys, because Chuck says this, major decisions are made at major events. So start throwing some events, start contributing, start giving back. You'll be amazed what happens. So don't think that you got to wait for Brent to throw an event or EXP to throw an event or Kyle Whistle to throw an event. Throw your own event. There's nothing stopping you except this little drunk monkey in your head. That's the only thing that's stopping you. All right, last thing I want to leave you guys with. We had a lot of quotes here. But this quote is what this company is all about. It's a Zig Ziglar quote. You can have everything in life you want if you will just help other people get what they want. So when we talk about the stock, when we talk about the revenue share, yeah, it's cool, whatever, there's money, we buy these big houses, that's great. But the way that happens is by helping others. We have this financial alignment where when somebody comes over, I don't win just because I got somebody here. I win by helping them. And the more I help them, the more I pour into them, the more I win. So pour into your people, and let's fucking win.